blackout. Go ahead, come on, get in place. Wait till they get into place.
Boxes and my mom's stuff. Found some old National Geographic magazines. On the cover were Sami people, reindeer herders, that on these funny hats and outfits and lived in what I think looked like teepees. When I told Chloe that my mom said I was part Sami, she was like, "No way!" And I was like, "Way!" They're sun worshippers, I think. Sami believe that rocks are alive and have a soul.
You believe it?
Singing is called yoiking. Sami's use drumming and yoiking to connect them to the spirit world and help protect them from harm. Guess we all could use that. I know I could. Especially with an ex-husband like mine. When I told Chloe that I was going to where my mom is from in northern Norway, 200 miles above the Arctic Circle, to a small farmhouse in the village of Ossebakken, she said, "No way. People can't go that far north. It's like frozen solid ice or something." Chloe's never been out of LA, so... Oh, I just realized I didn't tell you my name. It's Jenny, or as they say here, Yenny. You can probably tell that I am not from Norway. I was born in Southern California. Los Angeles, LA, Hollywood. Grandma Marie died, she left this old house to my mom. Now my mom's gone too, and I'm the only one left, so I'm stuck with it. I guess if I'm gonna get rid of this old house, I better get started. This journal in English because I do not want anyone to know my thoughts. My journey really began in the springtime, 1940, on a mountaintop of our island, Andorra. April 1st, 1940. This is my awakening. Marie? Marie?
Marie? Yeah?
I have something to tell you, Lee.
Lee? No, you know I'm not Lee. I'm her daughter, Marie. What is it, Angelina?
No, I can't remember.
It's okay, you'll remember.
Marie, are you listening?
Yeah, Teresa.
Hurry up with those clothes.
Almost done.
Don't let her boss you around.
It's okay.
You're not Lee. You're her daughter. Oh, Marie, the teacher.
Did you feed the animals?
Yeah.
Sit here and keep me company.
She'll be mad.
Oh, she's always mad.
Angelina?
I remember. In my dream, the darkness was coming.
Darkness, it's springtime and the sun is back.
It was terrible.
Nothing could be terrible on such a beautiful day.
Did you not hear me?
The whole village heard you.
Aunt Olafina says darkness is coming.
Take your fortune telling and get out.
You don't mean that, Teresa.
Hans died young because he married this crazy Laplander.
Sami, not Laplander.
My mama told me about the spirit world talking to us through dreams.
Your mama believed in the old ways. It is not Christian.
Ooh, darkness.
Go make yourself.
Now, Marie, here are some herbs.
What are they for?
You can make tea. Here, try.
Maybe the darkness is the war.
I will not have this talk of war.
Go ahead, it's good for you.
But, and Olaf, still in the arm.
Dear, I know.
Delicious. No!
Maybe you should drink your own poison.
Living with you is like drinking poison.
Oh, God, what is it now?
Good day, my fine ladies.
Hans, you're home!
This is Mr. Malter.
Oh, I know that.
Here you go.
We are not invalids. We can carry our own groceries.
I ordered them.
And did you pay?
And this time is fine. Marie, is your husband still in the army?
Yeah, still in the army.
What does he think about the Altmark incident?
Altmark?
The British violated our neutrality.
Oh, yeah, the Altmark.
But will Germany respect Norwegian neutrality?
Of course.
Well, what does your husband think?
I'm not sure. What's wrong, Mr. Malter?
Nothing, it's not to worry, I'm fine.
No, there's something.
It's Germany.
The war!
I told my wife enough with the war already, but she's worried.
War? No, we are neutral.
But the Jews have lost everything in Germany.
Really?
I should tell you, the Nazis have taken all of their businesses, forced them out of their homes into Jewish ghettos.
Oh, that's horrible.
Nazis!
Maybe the Nazis will come to Norway.
We are fine here.
Open your eyes, Teresa.
What are you going to do?
Well, my brother and his family escaped to the United States. Now my wife thinks we may have to leave, but I told her no. I can't leave my business. My home. But I shouldn't bring my troubles into your home.
No, I want to know.
I hope that
Olaf is doing well. Now, good day to you.
Such a nice man.
He's a Jew who cares only for his money.
You should talk, you old tightwad.
Mr. Malter and his wife, Wilhelmina, are the only Jews on the island. They are nice people. It must be hard to be so isolated. There are so many people who don't like Jews, so I don't know why.
Hello, get a clue. Anti-Semitism's been around for like a long time. I've seen Schindler's List like 15 times, I think.
I'm home, you lucky people!
You've always been nice to me. You have a lot to learn.
What? She knows a lot. Marie's a school teacher.
A substitute teacher. Take your boots off, you old goat.
Oh, my sweet life.
Won't be long until I can put in the potatoes. Looking forward to fishing with Olaf when he gets home.
I hope he's okay.
He is fine. We are all fine. Anders, did you eat all of the cinnamon coffee?
I need something sweet for my remedy.
There's more.
You should have a doctor look over you, Olafina.
For herbal remedies are worthless.
Are you a doctor?
He won't go. I have tried to take her to a doctor.
Ah, what do they know?
Take the clothes upstairs and put them away. I'll make some sandwiches. Olafina, you can help.
I'll help me, not you.
She's Marie, not Lee. How many times do I have to tell you? Oh, never mind.
You okay?
It'll be better when Olaf comes home.
Will it? Things weren't so good before he left. Is he
but things have not been the same since.
Huh. Happy marriage. I tried to fix my marriage many times. Useless. I guess that marriage is running the family.
How about the bedroom, you know?
No, not good.
Surprising, I never had children. Hans was a tiger.
His drinking makes him crazy.
Hans got drunk one time. Tried to tell me what to do. Naturally, I let him have it.
Naturally. He doesn't trust me.
That's dumb.
He wants to separate. What would happen to you and me then?
Well, I won't stand for that. And neither should you.
Drinking has a way to handle problems? Well, let's see. My grandfather, my father, my ex, well, he liked his Jack Daniels every night. I don't have a drinking problem.
What?
Wine is good for your heart. I drink, but I'm not a drunk. I'm a connoisseur.
I love American music and American dancing.
Dance! Don't wait until you're too old.
Turn it up!
While I was dancing, the Germans were on their way to invade Norway.
What in the world? Turn off that
music! Oh, my!
It's decadent devil's music over there.
Music today? What would Teresa think? Against the Russians to help the Germans. Wait, who? Russians? Germans? What? Okay, well, she writes 2 months later, June 16th, 1940, and the Battle of Narvik is lost. I always wondered why Norway was so important to the Germans. This place is so remote. I had to Google it, that's how Norwegian I am. Nazi Germany wanted to control all of the iron ore coming into Norway from Sweden, and they used the Norwegian coast to attack Allied shipping. King Haakon refused to accept a German government and then was forced to leave Norway. He escaped. Maybe we should escape?
I still can't believe it.
I saw this coming.
What are you two talking about?
The German invasion.
I told you.
They are here to help us.
Do you really think so?
German propaganda.
We got a letter from Ludwig. You should read it.
Oh, I read it.
Me too.
He loves the Germans, and he said England was going to invade Norway.
They would have if Germany had not come here to protect us.
He is it propaganda.
The Germans know what they are doing.
Sure they do.
We are all Nordic people. Martin Luther was German.
This is not about your heritage. This is war.
Maybe you should worry more about feeding his family and less about politics.
How can I? All out fighting the war and we're short on supplies?
Lotta, Teresa has enough opinions for all of us.
Yeah, she does. What are you looking for?
If only people would put things back where they found them.
What?
Hitler has restored Germany. Maybe he can do us good here in the war.
You sound like a national socialist.
Her and Ludwig. Hans was a communist, you know.
We can learn a lot from Germany. How to culture beautiful music.
Yeah, if you like marching music.
The sooner we accept this, the better off we will be. I found it. Time for your song.
Yeah, this is usually how she ends arguments.
My mom said that there are two things that Norwegians do that nobody else does. Eat lutefisk, salted dried codfish soaked in lye, and take Tron. Yuck. Tron is cod liver oil. Norwegians take it to keep them healthy, especially in the winter.
How can something so good for you taste so horrible?
Cod liver oil is nature's medicine.
Ludwig also said we should join the National Unity Party.
There's only one thing worse than a Nazi, and that's a Norwegian Nazi.
I think they are patriots.
You do realize that Olaf fought the Germans in Narvik?
A mistake.
They're here to take over, not help us.
We have always had good relations with Germany. They would not do us any harm.
They are harming us. Olaf is fighting them right now.
He is being misled by British propaganda.
He is our
son. I know he is our son, but Ludwig said...
He's a crazy Nazi. What do you expect him to say?
Olaf! Anders Reza! I was worried. Are you hurt?
Just some shock. I'll be fine.
What happened?
We fought the Germans in Narvik, then we left.
Yeah, we should not fight the Germans. What do you mean we left?
The British abandoned us, left us to die.
Now you are safe.
Oh, yeah. We should celebrate.
Celebrate? What are we celebrating?
Your safe return.
The Germans may force us to fight.
For them?
Maybe.
No, never.
We can't let the Germans know that I fought against them in Arden. I'd end up in a prison camp, or worse.
We could say that you were here at home the whole time, helping me fish.
Everyone in the village knows he was in Narvik.
Yeah, that's true.
We cannot lie. If the Germans ask, we will say he was forced to fight in Narvik.
We'll figure this out.
So, what's been going on here on the island?
A lot of naval activity.
A British ship was sunk on the north end of the island.
With all these warships, it's hard to go fishing. Every time I go out, I get questioned.
These two should have some time alone.
Yeah. Okay.
Nothing will be the same.
What do you mean?
I can't explain. You wouldn't understand. You weren't there.
I'm here for you now.
Look at me. Look at me.
I am. You look fine. Your letters, they were upsetting.
What do you expect? War is upsetting.
It just seems like you've stopped trying.
Oh, let's be honest.
We used to be in love.
Love? I don't know.
Thought you'd be happy to be home.
How can I be happy? Not helpless.
Maybe we can leave. Like you said, we can't risk the Germans finding out about you fighting in Narvik.
No!
We can leave and get a new start, you know, in America.
You mean run away.
No,
forget it! We ran away in Narvik. No more running. What about Mama and Papa? Olafina. Go ahead. Run away to America. I won't stop you.
No, we'll stay.
I can't get it out of my mind.
What?
Death everywhere, and for what?
What can I do?
World War has come to Little Norway. So why not escape? And why did she stay here for the rest of her life? Grandma Marie loved America. To be honest, I came here to sell this old house and escape from everything back then. To be honest, I just want to get rid of everything, every part of my past. Here I am, at the end of the world.
Everything. My marriage is over. I hate my job. I hate my apartment. Life. I hate the whole dating scene. E-Harmony, give me a break. More like e-bullshit. I know, it sounds like I'm complaining. I am complaining, of course. But the more I read, the more I want to know what happened. Why didn't she escape? I don't understand. November 5th, 1941. The past few months have been terrible. Olaf is drinking even more, and I walk on eggshells around him. Olafina and I cannot get thrown out. My work at the school keeps me going. German troops spread out across Norway after the April 1940 invasion, and now they are here. We are close to Narvik, which seems to be of great importance to them. Over 2,000 German soldiers are spread across our little island. What will we do? What will I do? What will I do?
Trace Nice, Olafina!
Is school out already?
The Germans shut down the school!
They take the schools to be used as barracks.
There are always rules. Certain parts of the island are off limits. No travel at night and checkpoints.
And they're taking all of our radios.
What are we going to do?
Fight, of course.
Well, so much for the Germans being helpful.
Be quiet, old woman.
Car approaches.
Open the door now!
What should we do?
Open the door, I damn you!
Well, I don't speak German, but I think you should open the door before they break it down!
Can I help you?
Are there any others here?
No, we are friendly.
Shut up! Outside! Outside!
Outside! You!
Outside!
Stop, please, please! Please stop! Please.
Sit down! Sit down!
Sit down.
Don't move.
You say we have to sit and not move.
That I understood. We have to cooperate.
What is she?
No, of course not. They are on our side.
Oh, really?
I want my nuts.
All of you be quiet.
Stay here! All clear!
Where is Hans?
It's all clear.
Yeah.
Colonel Richard Stryker. Is this the Strand resident?
Yeah, Colonel. Teresa Strand. You speak Norwegian?
Yeah, something.
I'm from Oslo. My father's family's from Germany. Welcome.
Excellent. And who do we have here?
Marie Strand. Good day, Colonel. He asked us our names.
Benta.
Marta?
Marta.
I understand some German.
You Norwegian women are quite lovely.
No, Colonel. Thank you, Colonel. What did he say?
Miss Trent, your home has been selected to be my office and living quarters during our visit to your island.
This is
my adjutant, Corporal Meyer.
It is nice to have German visitors.
Yeah, Meyer is Austria. Get my badge.
The wind blows differently today. Hans? Where are we?
I'm so tired of reworking. It's okay, Aunt Olafina.
It's okay.
than 20 years, you old fool.
Is there something wrong with this woman?
She's old, sick, and senile.
Odd looking. Is she a gypsy?
Lefman.
Sami!
Ah! Indigenous. We'll take good care of Norway and our people.
Angel Athena, this is Colonel Stryker of the German army.
Pleasure, madame. Germany has come to protect Norway's neutrality against Franco-British aggression.
Yeah.
I noticed the Norwegian flag. Soon we'll be flying the flag of the father. Yeah.
Certainly, Colonel.
I like that. He sits back from the road and is surrounded by one careful tree. Has a good view of the fjord and the village seems quiet. How many working age men are there in his household?
My son is 22, but he's a cripple. My husband's an old fisherman. I saw they're both heading back.
All young men will be working for us as guest workers, part of our labor service. Maya!
Yeah, Colonel?
Put them in the living room. You will have the rest of the house.
Colonel.
The young man will need to report for work immediately.
My son is cripple, unable to work.
What is that? I believe the odd woman is having a fit.
She's doing the traditional Sami singing. Crazy now.
Well, make it stop. I don't want to hear that noise.
The Colonel doesn't want to be disturbed while he's working here.
Yeah.
And he requires a lunch each day. Breakfast is usually coffee. He doesn't eat meat.
Maria did not get all that he said. The Colonel only wants coffee for breakfast. He wants a lunch and he doesn't eat any meat. Oh, like the Fuhrer.
Yeah.
No guests in your house are allowed while the Colonel is here. Very important. The premises are to be kept clean and tidy. Is that understood?
No guests.
Yeah. Well, you got the leadership for the paint clean up.
Yeah, you must make sure the paperwork is in order.
Where is my knife? Sami are good with knives. We kill with a knife if we have to.
You haven't killed anyone with a knife, have you?
You don't know what I've done.
You need to take your medicine.
Our mission here is vital, and we have to take extreme precautions to make sure nothing stands in the way of our success.
Certainly, Colonel. Perhaps I can show you around the top.
Sees you.
Oh, I'm so afraid of an Austrian.
Did you forget? Hitler is Austrian.
You need to keep her out of sight. You won't listen. Are you trying to get us all killed, old woman?
Are we going to let them move in and take Olaf?
No, we don't have a choice. We have to be careful. And you, remember there's a fine line between acting crazy and being crazy.
Olaf! What are you doing here?
Nothing! Live here!
What is he saying?
Anders Olaf, this is Colonel Stryker and Corporal Meyer.
Mr. Strand, I presume.
Yeah. Do you speak Norwegian?
Chewy, from what?
The Russians did this to my son, Colonel.
Finland went to war.
Good. But, did you fight against us in Narvik?
No, he fought bravely against the Russians, Colonel. He is crippled, as you can see.
In your present condition, we can't use you.
What did he say?
He's safe.
Wait, do you read and write German as well as you speak?
I learned in school. Oh, she's the best, Colonel. Very clever.
Take a word from me. Meyer is useless when it comes to office work.
Marie, we need the money.
What did you say?
What's going on?
You will have to join the party to work for us. You can begin later this afternoon.
Of the German Reich now!
Colonel Stryker offered Marie a job.
What? Why?
No!
Of course she will take the job.
Absolutely not. Everyone will hate
us. That is crazy.
Joining the Nazi party will be a big mistake for Marie and for us.
How else will we survive? Ludwig joined, we should join.
Oh, you're thinking of joining? You're not what like this it is.
Ludwig? He was on the German side in World War I.
Yeah, he was.
It is practical to accept what has happened.
I don't know what else we can do.
What about Marie's teaching job?
The schools are closed.
We should leave, like the others. Let that Nazi have the house.
Maybe we can go to America.
No! This is my house! Our house! It's been in my family for more than 100 years.
We have to fight!
All else right!
If we fight, they will kill all of us.
Well, I've said what I think. I'm tired and my bones hurt.
I'll find you some medicine, Uncle Lufina.
I have a remedy. My herb!
I need something stronger.
It is a matter of survival now. Maybe the Germans can help.
Maybe?
What's the use? Don't you understand?
Clear to me they're not.